Doing astrophotography, or EAA, you remember that moment when you want so much to catch that object, but you never do it because nothing appears on your monitor? Besides, you don't have a go-to. So I will show you an excellent and easy way to find any object with any telescope, with a camera and a laptop. Let's watch it. Let's choose an hard one. For example, the Elephant Trunk Nebula. We point more or less where we think it is, in the sky. We change the files to PNG files. We take a snapshot, it will save it in the computer. Then we upload that snapshot to astronomy.net website.
Please subscribe and give it a like!
You wait a bit and then it will start processing the image. Then just wait a bit more for the process to finish. Be patient. Meanwhile, you'll be opening the Stellarion software to be prepared for the next procedure. Click on the search window and return to astronomy.net. The process is finished, so now click on Go to Results page. Astronomy.net identified different objects, choose one and memorize it to use it on Stellarion. Now insert that number with the letters in the search window on Stellarion and it will slew to that object. Now Stellarion has identified the star, which is the object we choose. And you can see our Elephant Trunk Nebula, it's a little bit to the left and up. Now we already know where we are, and you were guessing, we want to move the telescope a little bit to the left and up to find the nebula. But we know we will point there and still can't see it because it is so faint. So our solution will be use LiveStack, the usual with EAA observation. It will save the day, better saying, the night. The weather is awful, with thin clouds, which is good for the demonstration. Auto stretch, the green again by the thin clouds. And then we start finally seeing something there. A little faint, but we see it. Now we just wait for the sharp cap to do its job, live stacking. And after some minutes of stacking and observing the object, the image will improve. Not too much because of the weather, but enough for us to see it. Now click on the link to the video you see in the screen to watch more interesting things I do with my Dobsonian telescopes.